time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Richardson is lined up and just about ready to send this one off as we're ready to get this game underway.
Sylvester fields it at the 11.
And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 39. The 49. So he keeps it and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
Complete. He's got room.
That's pretty impressive. Accuracy is important, but just as important is having receivers that can make plays.
From the 36-yard line, it's first down. And he is drilled at the 43-yard line.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
It off as he's hit, completes. He's tackled at the 23. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 23. Strike to the receiver.
It's a fumble.
And they fall on the loose ball.
It's not like receivers don't practice hanging onto the ball all week. This is just a case of the defense creating a turnover.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
Now he tries to buy some time. He decides to run with it.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
First and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Quick throw. Tackle made around the 40-yard line.
Well, we get a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
Around the 18-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 18.
got some open field. And he's taken down at the 8.
That's a good turnaround there. That'll make it second and inches.
Finds his receiver. Touchdown.
Positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he converts the extra point.
A nice five-play, 83-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 7-0.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Rams are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
That's a great tackle at the 28. Williams gains around 3 yards on the run.
Just a great job here by the defender of timing the hit and getting him down.
It's 2nd and 7. Ball on the 28.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. 6-yard pickup.
Well, he really didn't have to do too much there to give himself a little room to make the catch. Catch the defense off guard with a play-action pass there, but by going to the ground, they didn't have much of an opening.
Salyer back deep to return.
Oh, excellent punt.
Tackle at the 24-yard line.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there when they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
He's lucky just to get back to the line of scrimmage on that option.
Second down and 10 to go.
Ball on the 24. Across midfield, at the 30, to the 20, to the 10, and he's all the way in for the touchdown.
Did you see how explosive he looked? He had his sights set on the end zone, and he was not going to be stopped.
The PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one.
The Rams really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter. Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 25. Gets it. He's in space. He's got the corner. They pick up a good 6 yards there.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. To his receiver, and they make the stop at the 49-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch. Textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49. And he hits him hard at the 41-yard line. Right around the 46-yard line. And we've reached the end of one. 14-0, Rams. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Five wide. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
These guys just don't seem to be on the same page, and they're going to have to be if they expect to win this game.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Gets it out. He's met immediately. That makes it fourth and long. Salyer will be the return man. He punt. No, he faked it. Oh, he got nailed on that one. And they'll take over on downs. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. And he's level at the 38. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Run to the outside. From the 32-yard line. First down. There's a strike complete. They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line. Drop back a yard.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
From the 33-yard line, second down. Quick throw, and he's got the tight end again. Inside the 10. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal.
He has a whole other dimension when he's on the field. He took that short pass and turned it into a huge gain, all because of his blazing speed.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They'll spread the field with five wide. And he's in there. Touchdown.
job and some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight, and it's tough to maneuver.
And he tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
No matter how much people want to talk about points and offense, I still think that the best offense is a great defense. When you put a zero up there, it makes it pretty easy on your own offense to go out there and win the game.
It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout.
Here comes the pressure.
Second down and seven coming up here. Ball on their own 28. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. And they get a few yards on the halfback option.
To punt.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
And they're coming after this punter. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He makes it to the 28-yard line.
Hawthorne's having a tough first two quarters, Kirk, right now. Can't hang his head, though, because he could be very important before this game's all over.
Good point. He's going to have to stay positive. This team's going to need him before this game is over. Right now, this team has the lead. He's not played well. Do not be surprised at all. This team will make some adjustments at halftime. They'll come out shooting again in the second half. And you know he's still going to be involved. And because of his big playability, he could just be one play away from making a game-changing play.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. He's at the 40. And he's finally brought down at the 28-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 28-yard line, it's first down. He's on the run. Brought down at the 25.
That's good for gaining 3 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Caught, and he's brought down quickly.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it third and 3.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Nice play to set up first and goal.
He had a couple of freight trains coming at him, but when they blitzed, it created a hole in the coverage, and they took advantage of it.
He tackles him for a loss.
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays, but if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
It's second and goal, 8 yards out. He's tackled at the 5.
That makes it third and goal. Number 80 was his
Kick is up, and it sails through the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. He'll take it from the two. Tackle made at the 16-yard line.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. 3-yard loss there.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
They line up at the 13. Second down. But he can't shake the defense. And that'll do it for the first half. Still plenty of football to be played. 24-0, Rams.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. The paper, the stats, all the previews say this game should be even. It's not even at halftime. In fact, it looks as if this squad just got pushed around. They got bullied out there in the first half.
One team's playing big boy football, the other team's playing peewee football. I mean, it's definitely been, it's been surprising to watch, but at some point, you just got to man up. I mean, you got to say enough's enough, and you got to respond, because you had opportunities in the first half, and every single opportunity, big boy football kept winning. The little guys got to make a play. I mean, you can only get pushed around so much and not respond to it. And right now, it's just been disappointing to watch.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, we always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Rams have put up 24 unanswered points. One team can't do anything wrong. The other team can't do anything right.
So we're just about ready to return to action.
He's got it out to his tight end. And down he goes at the 33-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Nice run up the middle. Come. He heaves it deep. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. The wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Richardson looks ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick.
And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
The Rams coaching staff's got to be elated over on the sideline about what they plan to do with this wide receiver and the plans coming to fruition.
Absolutely, and they continue to be able to find ways to give him the football. That's the thing that's been probably most impressive, not just his ability, but how they've moved him around and got the football to him in different ways. It makes it very tough on the defense.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Tackled around the 41-yard line. From their own 41-yard line, first down. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's taken down at the 20.
I'm telling you right now, when you have that kind of speed, you're a real threat to go all the way. So that could have been even worse for this defense.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. Tackle made at the 18-yard line.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down.
Touchdown!
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
Converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Rams had that hot hand on offense, and they just keep on going here in quarter number 3.
The greatest thing you could say about these guys today is consistency. They are moving the football and putting points up on the board. They're going to be tough to beat. The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
That makes it 2nd and 8.
From their own 27-yard line. Second down. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Let's go, D. Let's go. 50's the mic. 50's the mic.
They give it to him again, and he's going to lose yardage. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of 1.
That'll make it 4-2.
Durbin is the punter. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Room around the corner. He'll take it from the 18. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Not sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against his defense.
They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
from their own 30-yard line. It's second down. Find his man, and they take him down immediately. The ball. Tackle at the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line. First down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And he tackles him hard at the 29-yard line. So the sack makes this a second and long. And he just gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he can't get away from the pressure.
That makes it worth it now.
Fourth and long here after the sack. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The offense will be hoping for a little more success than they had the last time out. And he's taken down at about the 43-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 43-yard line. We head to the fourth. 31-7, Rams. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
We ain't giving up nothing. Hey, check Mike 46.
Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line. From the 30-yard line, it's first down. And they make the stop right around the 22-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Complete. He's got room. Brought down at about the 11.
First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 11-yard line. Now he's scrambling. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's tackled at the 5-yard line.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
Throws quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown. He makes the PAT. Re-
Richardson.
Ready to kick.
And he got all of this one. Great kick.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Rams have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it's set up their offense to be able to score points.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries.
There's a strike complete. He's hit and taken down.
Second and five, ball on their own 30.
The quarterback in the gun with five receivers.
Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 49-yard line.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Out of bounds at the 43.
To the end zone. Doesn't get there.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. They'll get him for a loss.
Not sure about that play call as they fail on fourth down.
And the defense looked like they were expecting option on that play. Great job to pin him up and cause the turnover on downs.
The offense will come out again hoping to have similar results as their last drive.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
He makes his way to about the 42. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42. Got an opening. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Game seven on the play. That'll make it second and four.
He's at the 20. He gets out to about the 14-yard line. First down. From the 14-yard line, first down. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. First and goal.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and goal.
And he is drilled at the 3.
No gain. That brings up second and goal.
That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, 38-7, Rams.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.